Hi, I'm Virginia with Bruce Clay Incorporated. Today we're going to talk about how to get found on Google.
It's going to be endless, endless fun. Endless.
Okay.
You have a business with a website, or you work with someone who does. So now you're thinking, how can I get found by people who are looking for me on a search engine like Google or Bing? In order to explain, first I'm gonna describe the makeup of a search engine results page, and along the way, we'll kind of describe how it all works. Sound good? Let's go. So the typical search engine results page has, we're gonna go with like five parts. First, there's the search bar. That's at the top of the search page. You use it to type in your query. Below that, you'll find ads. Now, these are marked with a little ad. These results show up because an advertiser has paid to be there. This is one way to get found in Google, and if you want to learn more about showing up in ads on a search and results page, you're going to want to look up PPC, that's short for pay-per-click, or SEM, search engine marketing. All right, let's go ahead and move on to the third part of the search engine results page. And that is your organic or natural listings. So basically what organic means here is results you don't have to pay for. What happens is Google and Bing have these super secret formulas that rank all the pages on the internet to figure out what's the best result for what the searcher is looking for. When we're trying to show up in the organic space, we're doing SEO. That's short for search engine optimization. What makes up SEO, you ask? Oh, so many things, and we're just gonna have to come right back around to that. All right, moving on, part four. This is gonna be your local results. And these are the ones that you see with a map and some star ratings, usually. When you're vying for one of these spots, you're doing local SEO. So the last section that I'm gonna describe is actually a lot of different search features, but they have this one thing in common. They're suggestions from the search engine to help the searcher find what they're looking for. Now this is gonna include a whole range of features like people also ask, search suggestions, people are also searching for, and then things like answer boxes, direct answers, knowledge panels, and oh my god, this is a lot of like SEO jargon. But basically, these are results that don't take the searcher off of the search results page. It's just more info there. So there's your suggestions. All right, I said we were gonna come back around to explaining how to show up in the organic listings. And this is what SEO comes down to at a really high level. The search engine's always gonna try to show the very best page on the entire web that does two things. It matches the searcher's intent and it matches the query. In SEO, when we're talking about matching the query, we're talking about keywords. You're gonna hear that a lot when you research SEO. Are you using the words that searchers are using to find your site? These are called keywords. Then there's the intent piece. Google's gonna try to figure out what the searcher's looking for. So, for example, if I say yoga studio, it's gonna know that I want a yoga studio in the vicinity near me. So here's what comes down to ranking in a nutshell. The search engine trying to figure out what the searcher is looking for, the content on your very own website, oh, and one third thing, people vouching for you on the web. You know how word of mouth marketing is so powerful? It's someone telling someone that a business they trust is doing great things. On the internet, the equivalent of giving props to someone are links, mentions, and reviews. Wow, that was a lot of information, and there's a lot more to SEO, but we can't be here all day. Go to the link in the description to see the SEO tutorial by Bruce Clay. It's got 18 steps, it's your SEO primer, and it even includes tools to analyze your site. And that, my friends, is a wrap.